first game, we have Spicy Bumblebee taking on hashtag go with a Karo Khan. Okay, he's bringing up his bishop. He's playing well, actually, because you want to get your bishop outside of this pawn chain you're going to create soon. So he's trading off. So far, I'm really impressed with what our sub is doing. I think it's a song. It's leveling him up, chat. It's leveling him up. Yeah, keep up the energy, everyone. Keep up the energy. So, let's see. This is 1 minute chess? No, this is 3 minutes. Don't allow bishop knight d6 check, because if you get checked, then you're not going to be able to castle. Knight f5, solid move. He's defending the d6 square. Now he has to protect his queen. Please don't Botez Gambit. Just a soft, gentle push up to d7. Can we just play queen d7? I know you guys are motivated because you want to see one of my closest friends roast me. I mean, if you don't win now, I lined up the incentives. The motivation is there. This is all on the subs. I know I'm not going to get jebaited this time. I know that everyone's going to try their best. Okay, queen a4, let's castle out of it. Don't allow any, you know, fossil moves over here. Beautiful. Spicy Bumblebee is playing very well so far. Very well. Very well. Okay. h4, this is a free pawn, isn't it? But we didn't take it. That's okay. It's a free pawn. It's still a free pawn. Okay, we're just gonna keep the free pawns. Can we restart the song? Oh, you mean so that chat doesn't go crazy, Gerber? Sorry. Okay. Rook c8. So we're bringing the rook on an open file here. Knight a4. So what is he trying to do? Knight b6 here? We gave away a piece after playing an incredible game. Oh, they were locked up. Sorry, Gerber. Sorry, Gerber. Okay. Yeah, no, the mod is on your side, chat. Well, we're going to enjoy the rest of the game. Rook d8. So we're down a piece and we're down on time, which I don't really know how it happened because we had a beautiful beginning where we were playing incredibly. Knight b6. Our rook is under... Oh, no. Why are we giving so many free pieces? Please take with the rook. Okay. We're down a full rook now. Don't worry, chat. Subs, let chat bring up the energy for the start of the stream, and then we're going to change it back to songs that, you know, are a little more tame. But we need to get the energy up, chat. So, what do you do? You're down a rook. You should move the rook to c8, Spicy Bumblebee. I feel much better about this. 1 minute... and 18. Oh, this is really unlucky. I think we're going to lose this unless there's a blunder. Because we're down on time and we're down a piece. But you know what? Chat has energy, so at least there's that. At least there's that. Maybe, we're pushing pawns in front of our king. I guess you got to be a little bit desperate in positions like this, chat. Wait, I'm being nice. We've blundered like crazy this game, and am I yelling? No. Not yet, that is. Not yet. Okay. We still have some chances. Can we get the rook maybe? Ooh. Okay. A check maybe. Try to go for some mate ideas. Or put your king back so that you lose a queen. I didn't think that was the ideal plan. I didn't think that was the ideal plan. But what do I know? We played such a good opening, and then I feel like there were two different players who played this. Like, there was an opening guru who's maybe like 1500, you know what I mean? And then like a 200 who blundered a little bit. Versus Milan Kao up next, ladies and gentlemen. What do we have here? We have an English defense. No, we don't. This is like a London. I don't know why I said it was the English. The English is when you have c4. This is okay. He's playing the opening very well. We got some under 1,000 Andes who play openings better than I do. Knight e4 is a little bit weird. You don't want to move your knight twice in the opening. So try to first bring out your other pieces. Something like rookie one. And e4 is actually a square you want the pawn to. But he's doing some, like, knight wizardry here. I don't know what's going on. The knights are linked. They're happy. And now they're retreating. Okay. Okay. That's all right, chat. That's all right. Oh, no. It's not all right. We're losing a piece here if he doesn't move it. Please move it. Try to just get rid of his knight. Get rid of his knight. Don't leave the knight there. Chat, this knight is attacked twice. Okay, that kind of works. That kind of worked somehow. That kind of worked. Okay, we tricked him. We tricked him. We tricked him. We'll take it. Okay. I mean, it was a free piece. It was a free piece, but he blundered into d5, so it worked. It's just, if your piece is attacked twice, instead of moving your defender away, so it's defended zero, maybe you defend it with another piece. But it worked out, chat, so we're okay. Let's go, Jackie T617 from Wales. From Wales, that's exciting. Let's fork him. Oh yeah, come on, knight. You know you see that D7 square. You know it's calling your name. You want it, don't you? No, you don't. That's okay. Rookie one is fine as well. It's still calling your name, though. D7, anybody? Okay, if he didn't see it the first time, he's probably not going to see it the second time. He saw it the second time! He is a god! Knight D7, ladies and gentlemen, watch out. This boy is going to the four digits of chess.com. Elo, big pogs for Jackie. Big, big pogs here. Very impressive. Very impressive. Very impressive. We're happy with this. Werwin, thank you so much for the 2 months. All right, cool. We're up an exchange being a rook for a bishop, so 2-point equivalent here. We're feeling good. This queen is trying to be aggressive, but you can't be aggressive without backup, you know? You don't send one person into a terrorist zone. You need an entire team of people. So that queen on h3, it's not doing anything. It needs backup. So we're not afraid. We're not afraid. We're just going to gobble, gobble, gobble. E takes f4. Ooh, he's bringing in the backup. We got to be careful because if the bishop gets on f3, if the queen is on e5, then we're going to get mated. We're going to get mated. Rookie one I like. We're bringing the rooks to the open file. I would be more comfortable if we just trade off queens. This queen is a little too close to the king. I don't like what's happening here. I don't like what's happening here. Okay, beautiful. Jackie is playing very well. King takes, okay. Can we play rookie 5 to not allow bishop d5? This is fine too. So what do you want to do here? You basically want to double your rooks on the one open file. We'll see if he gets that plan. Ooh, yeah, bishop c4 would have pinned the rook, but that's a free rook. Let's take it. Let's take it, finish him off. Beautiful, sir, beautiful. And now just simplify. Trade off all the pieces. You're up an exchange. And a rook. You can even sacrifice your rook for a bishop. We're gonna get this win. We're gonna get this win, chat. There's no... Okay, we could flag. I was gonna say there's no way we can lose this, but, you know, where there's a will, there's a way, and I've been surprised many times during these sub-battles, but so far we're doing okay. So far we're doing okay. Okay, so far so good. G takes, attack that bishop, take it. Let's, nice, this is good. Or not. I mean, we don't have to take the bishop. We can go for the mate. No flag, 37 seconds to 55. There's no way he can protect this pawn though, so we're gonna grab it. Or we're gonna go promote, this is fine too. He did something very good. The best positioning for your rooks is often to have them doubled on the 7th rank, so he knows his chess basics. He's not giving his opponent any counterplay. There's no reason. Just get rid of that pawn. Go get that queen. Go checkmate him. 30 seconds. You can do it. He can do it. I believe. And mate in one, baby. Let's get it. Or mate in a few. As long as we don't flag. As long as we don't flag. I'm not greedy, chat. If you don't checkmate right away, but you get the win, that's all a girl coach can ask, okay? I mean, any coach. We'll be right back. But don't give your queen. I'm not even picky. Okay, get another queen. That's fine. Get another queen. But don't give it up this time. Keep the queen. Keep the queen. Keep the queen, please. Just keep the queen. We're going to keep the queen and we're going to be happy about this. We're 11 seconds. Please don't flag. Ladder format. Ladder format. And then mate him. Come on. Just give him the mate. Just give him the big... Bring it over. Bring it over. 5 seconds. We did it, chat. We did it. We did it. We did it. Chat, you are champs. And by champs, I mean we're finally tying, which is basically a win in my eyes. Supportive, supportive, supportive. Okay. E4, I think Destiny plays. Please don't go. Don't go for the 4-move checkmate. All right. He's not going to be able to because the guy's playing the King's Gambit. Quark is playing some risque chess over here. So Destiny already has a better position. We're trading off. If he takes with a pawn, Destiny can even trade queens. He can trade queens if he wants. And then white will have to retreat his knight. This is fine. Although, now Destiny's king is going to be in the center of the board. So usually you would prefer to be the one taking than the one who has to take back, right? Because now his king hasn't castled. All right, he's in check now. He can defend with the knight or he can move out of the way. Both are solid options. King c8 we like. This is okay so far. He's playing well on the clock. We know that he's practiced with 15 second chess, so at least he's not gonna flag. Is he gonna develop his pieces ever? Destiny, I know you like pushing pawns. I know you like pushing pawns, but we would like to maybe see some other pieces develop. Yeah, chat, if you want to watch from his point of view, it's twitch.tv/destiny. All right, the pawn on d6 is hanging, and his opponent sees it. Oof. Okay, let's not lose the bishop. There's not a lot. I think he might have to even just retreat bishop d7. The eval bar is giving his opponent the advantage of a rook, even though he's only up a pawn, because Destiny has not... Stop pushing your pawns! Destiny, develop your pieces, man! Okay, take... Oh, God. Oh, God. Alright, we lost a piece, but we're finally developing. We're finally developing! We're finally developing, chat, it's okay. I feel bad. It's because he's been playing so much 15-second chess. All right. So let's get our king out. Let's maybe bring our rook so that he doesn't play rook d7. Very nice. 2 minutes of 145. Come on, Destiny. You can save this. You're just down a piece, and at 1,000, just down a piece means nothing. You can try to be aggro like knight b4. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. His mind is developed for 15-second chess. Well, I expect him to flag his opponent then. Honestly, just take the pawn and trade. Usually, when you're down a piece, you don't want to trade. But at this point, having to deal with a passed pawn would have been a lot worse. He's now threatening this pawn as well. Don't give up any material, though. Okay, this is a trade. We'll take those. Just bring your knight back. Nice. Now we're going to lose this pawn. Or not. Check. Okay, we'll take it. And then he can actually defend his pawn. Destiny's playing better all of a sudden. His opponent is getting low on the clock. This is better. Oh, he didn't protect it. Okay. Maybe bring your king back to defend the pawn. Or go up and not defend your pawn. That's okay. Nobody seems to care about this pawn. These players are just really not caring about the pawn. And now things have been traded. I don't like trading when you're down material because now he has to deal with a knight, which is just going to be a serious menace here. At least when you have a knight, it gives you better drawing chances. That being said, a minute 28 to a minute, there's possibilities that Quark might make a mistake under time pressure. I don't think they're very high. Good. Try to save that one lonely pawn. And now he has to move his king. This is tough. Okay, you gotta go try to catch that guy. Well, you can't catch him anyway. Okay, you might as well push. Go for it. Try to promote. If he would have pushed, he would have promoted because his opponent is pre-moving. He would have gotten a queen had he pushed his pawn. All right. Everybody pray for stalemates. pray for stalemates. It's possible we're going to see a draw. Either a stalemate. Can I see some praying emotes in the chat, please? Stalemate or flag his opponent. Oh, no. His opponent's getting another queen. Oh, man. This is tough, chat. This is tough. Okay, his opponent only has 35 seconds. Oh, no. He should have tried to hide behind the horse. Stalemate, baby! Stalemate! Holy smokes, chat. Destiny figured it out. He did it, chat. He did it. Wait, I want to hear him. I want to hear him. Did he even know he did this?
Okay.
Pepe. Let's go, sad Pepe. You take down this normie who doesn't even have a profile photo. Where are you from? I think you played for us before. Zambia. All right, chat. We got our Zambian king here. He is going to take back what is ours, which is finally a win for the sub battles. Finally a win. Rainbow scoreboard. Yes. I don't know why that one. I think that one is highlighted. All right, let me fix this too so that it's even. 1.5 to 1.5. Oh, I think I could have just done update scores. Yeah, it updated the scores. Okay, there we go. Nice. 1.5 to 1.5. All right, so Adeem is playing this very well. He's playing one of those openings that if you don't like opening theory, you can play. You don't usually get an advantage as white, but you're not losing either. So it's very solid. Whoa, this computer says this is a blunder. Is it just because we're losing this pawn? But that was a big blunder. Okay, let's protect this
Couldn't
pawn.
Express my prayer for draw in chat because emote bless RNG is no more.
Oh, it isn't? Well, thank you so much, quickly can't pray. Appreciate it. I didn't know that you couldn't. Yeah, so we protected this pawn. This is good. And now he's trying to gang up. Knight f1 is a counterintuitive move because you have to move your knight backwards to protect this pawn. Wait, what is bless RNG? What do you mean it got... Oh, he got canceled. Oh, the guy whose emote was canceled? Really? I didn't know that. Emote from a banned streamer. Okay, good to know. I didn't know. All right. Okay. So, knight takes e4. We got our knight in the center of the board here. Unfortunately, we have this pawn that's hanging. There's a lot of discovery attacks here. But we also have to deal with bishop e3. Our king moves. At least the f2 square is protected by the knight. He can even sack. I mean, there's a lot of nasty tricks here, which is why the computer doesn't like our position. And this looks like a good move if he pushes his knight back, but I think there's some tricks here. And we're also creating weaknesses. Yeah, knight e3 is kind of a pain in the brain. I guess we can move our queen away to e2. And there's just gonna be no way to kick this knight out. Is this song on loop? No, it's just an 11-minute song. I don't know why it's so long. It's the extended version. Sorry, chat. Sorry. But there's only 2 minutes left. You guys want me to change it? I mean, it's almost over, chat. There's a minute left. Alright, so discovery attacks coming in now, but we want to get... Ooh. This is concerning because it can bring... Oh, that's a free queen. Sorry, that's wrong. Why is this concerning? Maybe like queen e7. It's actually not that concerning. I'm glad you got out of the way. Knight c2, does that work right away? No, because the rook is protected. Rook has to be protected. Queen e7, protect the rook, and then you can play knight c2. Sorry, chat. Okay, so queen e7, good move. And then you can also try to activate with your other rook. Now we have to take care of the c2 threat. Honestly, I would even try something like c4 temporarily, but then the knight can still go to c2. If you play rook e2... Rook e2 seems like an attempt here. Rook e2 to defend the c2 square. But now that the pawn is there, the queen isn't going to protect the rook anymore, so it's a little bit worse. Oof. Okay. This is creative. We're attacking the rook. Oh, take the rook! He blundered! He had to protect his rooks first. Because now we're actually better. Chat! Shady baby blundered! This is good! Can I get the bar on the left when you're playing? Honestly, the bar trips me up, but I hope it helps you guys. Okay, so now if he takes, we take back with the bishop and we're up a full piece. Ooh, that's a free pawn. Oh, and a free bishop is what I meant. I wasn't talking about taking d4. I was saying about taking the free piece. Obviously, now it's a free pawn. Oh, I would have taken with the knight first because you want to get your bishop, because then you could have gone for checkmate. But he's simplifying 1 minute and 10 seconds versus 25 seconds. Chat, I was joking to make you feel better about your own chess. Okay, cool. So we're trading off. You have a rook and a knight. What do you do here? You're up 1 minute. You just take all of your opponent's pieces, okay? You play with your food. You say, hey, buddy, if you're not going to resign, I'm going to make you suffer and show you what a fool you are by taking all of your pieces. I bet you don't enjoy this game, do you? That's okay, because I'm going to destroy you. That's what you do. That's what you do. 7 seconds. This is good. Don't stalemate him, though. He still has these pawn moves. We're fine. If you check, it can't be a stalemate. Boom, baby. Queen takes and then checkmate. Let's see it. Oh, that checkmate works too. Aww, Adeem did it. Adeem, our Zambian king, with the knockout blow against Shady Baby. Inuyasha is my team player. Liked Inuyasha. Okay. 1 sec. It's getting really hot in my room. I'm going to turn on the AC. I'm not skipping the song, chat. Okay. So what is going on here? Whoa, the computer loves our position already. Why does the computer love it? It must be because of something to do with this long diagonal. You have to be careful whenever you push a move like this. Yeah, chat, we do have a Reddit. If you haven't joined it yet, please post memes. We review it like once a day on stream. But if we don't have enough memes, we're going to have to review it less often. Okay. Queen b3 is defending the pawn on b4. I like it. C6. It's always smart to challenge a pawn in the center. But I think we're not taking advantage of the mistake that Alg made. So that's why something like e4 would have been good. Okay. Knight c7. I think this was unnecessary. We could have tried to develop our bishop first. So remember, if you've already developed a piece, try not to move it twice and get your other pieces out first in the opening. Bishop d7, very calm developing move. I'd be happy with it. Now e4 is played, so we're not going to have any more tricks on the long diagonal. He's playing knight h5. I think he's trying to push f5, which is a very common idea in the King's Indian, but it's not necessarily good in this position because it's going to create some weaknesses for us as well. That being said, the only other idea he could have went for was like a queenside pawn storm. Need more drama material to post there because you're not good with memes like Gunta. Jimmy GG's, I still have to apologize to Llama for the roasting of Diablo 2. I feel a little bad. Ooh, I think Queen C4 just is crushing here because if you play Bishop E6, then a Knight G5 attacks the Bishop and we're going to lose the Knight. Okay, he didn't see it. Can we please put our Knight back or move the King out of the way? This is okay too because we can take here. Take the knight. This is the only move. If you retreat your knight, we're going to lose after knight g5. You have to take the knight here. Bishop takes e4, queen takes, and then move the knight. It's a nice move because it's defending the knight as well. I'm sorry, chat. Okay, he's doing it. He's doing it. I know. I'm sorry, chat. So he can either defend or move his knight away. This is good. Because his knight on the rim wasn't doing much, you know? You don't gotta spend that much time on the rim. Knight f6. Rook c8, bringing his rook to an open file. We're doing it, chat. We're playing incredible chess here. Get out of that pin. Get out of that pin. Kachi hyper. Okay, not that rim, chat. Jeez. Ooh. The problem is now if he moves his knight, don't let yourself be pinned for so long. Get out of that pin. Get out of that pin, dude. Or not. No, he didn't, Jimmy. I don't believe you. Okay. So, he's threatening to take the knight, which is defending his knight. So, if he plays queen f7, then he's going to defend his knight a second time, and he doesn't have to worry about the pin anymore. Okay, so queen f7. Anything else that's going to work here? Ooh. This is... Oh, I think he would have had to take with a knight. Yeah, so we're down a piece. We're down a piece and we have 30 seconds to minute A. I think we're going to lose this game. Oh, yeah, so the whole problem in Inuyasha's position was the pin. He just wasn't dealing with it, and that was an issue. Okay, bishop takes g5. At least it distracts the rook from the pawn, but you probably want to keep your piece here. Honestly, for practical chances, it's better keeping it. I would have liked if he brings his king in. The king is a very important piece here, but he's playing quickly, so I have to respect it. Keep playing quickly and I'll respect it. Good, good, good. Pre-moves are good. I mean, we're probably going to lose this, but at least he's pre-moving, so maybe his opponent will be slow. Ooh, nice trap. If the pawn takes, we're going to get the rook. Okay, take with the pawn. Nice! We got a pre-move king over here. Like, if he wasn't already lost, he's quite good at bullet. He's doing very well. He's actually catching up. He's almost at half of his opponent's time. Good. Keep thinking, Al. Keep thinking. This is promising in terms of flagging capabilities. This is the best fast play I've seen from one of our subs in a long time. 8 seconds. I'm just impressed with how quickly he's tried. Yeah, I know it's not. Come on, come on. Pre-move pawns. Pre-move. Ooh, he's spending a lot of time now. He doesn't have to spend time. He's going to lose regardless. Like, you shouldn't be thinking of the best moves when you have 2 seconds and you're down. Like, the only chance is your opponent's dog comes in, takes a poop, and, you know, distracts your opponent for 10 seconds. Kind of like what happened to Charlie. Yes, on Friday. Care of the pin if you're still here. Don't worry, you don't have to apologize. You played well. Just move out of the pin next time. All right, Jameson TY versus Hermione 117. All right, got a knight in the center. Are we going to try to trade it off or bishop e3? They both work. They're blitzing out theory here. Okay, we've got some theoretical Andes here. I respect it because you guys do what I can't, you know? Although now that I have to shave my eyebrows if I'm not 2300, I might actually start being a theory Andy. You fix colors but not score? The score is going to update. I should be able to click update scores. But I don't have authorization. Okay, let me give it 1 second. This is a pain. Okay, we're doing a script for this, and to edit it, I have to give permission, but it's going to take a while. So I'm just going to update it manually. Subs are playing against each other. Time to read Dvoretsky. Dvoretsky is, like, if I'm improving in blitz, like, if your goal is to play better 3-0, know your openings well and your tactics, and that's going to give you a huge boost. At least for me. Ooh, this is beautiful. Look at that queen. That rook is attacking the queen. So it's a discovery attack. We just won a piece, and now we're going to take another bishop here. That's amazing. This pawn is under attack because it's attacked twice. H3. Ooh, Jameson, you are playing this like a pro, dude. Chief CJ, thank you so much for the 2 months. I really appreciate it. Thanks so much for supporting the channel, sir. Okay. So what is he trying to do? I respect Hermione here. Hermione is really going for the counterattack. Queen d4 and taking the pawn is a beautiful tactic if he spots it. Because whenever you're down a piece, you want to go for a desperado. Basically, inaccurate play that increases your chances that your opponent makes a mistake. And that's what we're seeing a bit of here. Okay, we're trading off. This is cool. The pawn is under attack. What do we want to do? Rook d4 is going to defend it. We can double up if we want to. This is gotchy. Dude, I love how now I get auto-played gotchy on my YouTube. Like, what's going on? What's going on? Alright. Rook d2, we're protecting. We're up a bishop here and a pawn. No, we're just up a bishop. Okay, cool. So what do you do when you're up a bishop? Well, look at the traps that your opponent can set up. So G2 is one trap. We're defending it. And on top of that, you have more pieces that you can use to attack your opponent's pieces. So E7, trade off, simplify. Trading off and simplify is easy to do as well. Ooh, don't allow this. Don't allow this. You need to protect that pawn. Okay, B4. Ooh, A5 here is kind of nasty. Thank you, James Brannigan. I thought he... Okay, you should actually push C4. Block it up. Block it up. Don't let him take with check. No, I said block it up. Don't... He must be opening up because I'm listening to Gachi. I am influencing them here. Now I think... Oh, shit. Sorry. The problem is, if our king ever goes to e5, he's going to cut off the rook from protection. So where's he going to run? Honestly, if we don't take a draw, we're going to lose. So we should take a draw. This is bad. That was the one trick. Remember what I said? What do you do when you're up material? Look at your opponent's one trick. One trick. Like, they usually have a couple tricks. And if you know them, you're not going to fall for them. All right, D7. Let's go. Let's try. Let's try to promote this pawn, sir. Please. D7. We got to try, I suppose. He has to play king F6 to get to E7. If he sees it, we're... King E7. Dude, why is he playing so well? He only has 20 seconds. Okay, 17 seconds. And he's not playing this super well. I think we can flag him. Get that king in there. Get that king in the house. Take his pawns, baby. Yes! 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 Why did we take the rook? Why didn't we take the rook, dude? There was a free rook. That's fine. Make up for it by flagging him. Don't give up pawns, dude. Now he's just gonna sack and draw if he knows what to do. All right, we got Rye X Hosk versus Nikens. She roasts me in return. Yeah, but that's because roasting is like a punishment for her. Oh. Why is everybody sending me so many? My family is messaging me. One second. Uh-oh. Is everything okay? Yeah, it is. All right, so here we have the center. Chat, we have the center. Things are going well. We got the center. The pawn on E4 is under attack. Can we protect it or push it? We'll take it. We'll take it. Sankai22, thank you so much for the Twitch Prime. Chat, on good news, I was feeling so nauseous this morning and such a bad migraine, and hanging out with you guys and Anna and with Chess must have helped because I'm actually feeling better. Oh, shoot. Oh, I thought we were winning. And I get really bad migraines. So I took medication for my migraine like 4 hours before, and it was still hurting. It was still hurting. And it's finally better. And it feels like somebody's pounding on my head. It was really bad. It was really bad. But now it's better. Now it's better, chat. So that's good. Which means I'm going to order food for after the sub battle. But let's pay attention for now. I'm going to order food on a game that we're like losing or something. Okay. Let's see. Can we take this bishop? When I see a hanging bishop, I like to take it. But knight f4, I like as well. I'm being wholesome. Yeah, a little bit. A little bit. Argus Wolf, thank you for following, buddy. Jay Alexandra Miss, thank you so much. Hello, Pepe's in the chat. Appreciate it, Jerry Lopez. Fighting Jack, thanks again for the gifted subs. I appreciate you guys. Okay, so bishop takes g2. Looks like a good idea here. So bishop takes g2, and we're going to attack the rook. Okay, we didn't play it. This is a weird move. I guess he... That was a really weird move. Okay. If we take, queen takes, our rook is going to be in the corner, and we're in serious trouble here. So what do we want to do? Can we block it up with d5? So basically, the problem that black has here is that his king is in the center of the board, and he's underdeveloped. So he really needs to come up with some Houdini plan. At least we're protecting f6 now. Like bishop e7, knight c6, queen c7, castle queenside, and get the heck on out of there, you know? I can order next game because you're winning. Wow, Vila. How long have you been waiting for that line? And why are you always playing for Team Anna, dude? It's so tilting. It's so tilting. The one person who actually works for Team Botez plays as a sub for Team Anna. It's actually a little bit tilting, chat. Anyway. Alright, that's fine. So we didn't get to castle. King f8, our king is going to be stuck on the side of the board. So what's happening? The knight is coming to e4, it is going to attack the pawn on f6. What are we going to do about this, chat? Well, I guess we're just going to continue developing and king g7 or king f... No, king g7 so that there's no checks. Ooh. This is actually okay, because... What are we trying to do here, though? For a second, I thought we were losing our pawn. I thought we were losing our pawn, that's why I like king g7. King g8 and then bring the rook to f8. Ooh, that's nice, that's nice. What is he doing here? Maybe he's trying to play king e7 and rook f8? I think he's trying to get his king to run. 59 seconds to 55, by the way. Yeah, no, Vila really tries. He's not a double agent. He's a freaking tryhard. He's like 13-year-old kids when Fortnite was hot, and they're there grinding every day after school, past their bedtime. That's what Vila does in sub battles. He brings out his best chess. It's very annoying. Anyway. Rook g6. We're attacking the bishop on g5. This is actually good. You want to trade a rook for two pieces if you can. 45 seconds. Time is going to be what happens here. Keep moving. Safe moves. Where's your king going? g8 was better. g8 was better, and then you bring your rook in. Why are we... This king has just been, like, courting the center, you know? This is a very centrist king, and I'm just telling you... Like, if you're a king, you probably have to be leaning more towards one side. Otherwise, your people are going to revolt. And that's what we're... Like, I'm just telling you. There's a lot of messages in chess that can also apply in other areas. 33 seconds to 20 seconds. Okay. Knight e7. Let's get the knight to g6 or something. We're trying here. We're trying. Queen g6 is going to allow check, but then we can hide. 13 seconds. We just need to play fast. Honestly, I don't even care. Oh, take his queen, baby. Let's go. Hey, maybe there is space in this world for a centrist king that's out there with his people. Maybe this game will be an inspiration. The question to the century old, is it better to be feared or loved? Finally solved. By Nikon, 1619 from Team Germany. Okay, let's go. 2 seconds to 9. Whoa, we're almost getting that mate, boy. We got a pre-move lad over here. Nikons, that was fantastic. That was fantastic. That was fantastic. I'm really proud of you. Change to winner point of view, maybe. I don't know if I'm walking on solid ground. How my buttercomies falling down. Sorry. To help me. I forgot to change the score. You're right. Let me change it. Sorry. No more singing. I'm done. I'm sorry. All right. We just lost like half our viewers. Not Burner. Thank you for the Twitch Prime. So. What is this? Opposite side castling, which is gonna mean aggression from both sides, the way we like to see it, because we are watching 20 First Century Chess. We are here for some excitement. We're watching the two 1700s battle it out. The big boys. Bull Bear 777, thank you for using your Twitch Prime here and not on Ludwig. Nexus 1, thank you for using your Twitch Prime here and not on Ludwig. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Did anybody watch UFC yesterday? It must have been so weird for the fighters who are used to having an audience and the energy of the audience just do it in front of their team. Anyway, you asked me about it like three times, Gerber. Oh, did you really? Honestly, I fell asleep before the final fight. But I was watching for a while. Dude, my headache started yesterday. I'm not good with watching TV. It sometimes puts me to sleep. Okay, so we got the bishop pair. This is good. Our pawns are really aggressive. I like this position. Knight c4 is intimidating, right? Because if he plays knight c4, he's going to win our bishop pair. The real Matt Damon, 6-9. Thank you for gifting 2 subs in the channel. Really appreciate it, sir. h5 I like. You're trying to pry open your king's position. This is good. I miss nothing. Okay, chat, one sec. I'm ordering food. I'm almost done. Because it's going to take a while. They're always late here. Okay. Free food for everybody. I'm ordering curry. I love Asian food. Asian food is my favorite. And while I eat, we can watch like a YouTube video of chat's choosing. Did I dye my hair? No, but I want to get a new haircut, a new hairstyle, because I actually feel like I'm molding. Okay, so this position is awesome. Are we gonna finally have somebody who takes down Vila? Old lady hair. I don't have old lady hair. You know what, chat? Can we help decide on like a new hairstyle? Because I'm ready to mix it up. But the thing is, I've only ever gotten highlights in my hair once, and it was very mild. So I've never actually dyed my hair or really cut it much more than this. Because I don't like that change with my hair. And also, dyeing your hair is really expensive and you have to upkeep it, you know? So I'm kind of a bland Stacy when it comes to hair dye. You know? So we're really winning. E takes f5, pawn takes, rook takes, and Pranov is actually just beating Vila out of the park. Holy smokes, this is kind of embarrassing. Vila, I thought you were going to play well today. A boring Karen? Yeah, maybe I did. What is going on here? Okay, E takes F5. Pawn takes, rook takes, and then we are gonna win this piece? Poor Vila. Yeah, you're right, I don't wanna jinx it, but Vila has 20 seconds, and I mean, this is a straightforward plan to see. He's doing his best to defend. How do you continue? You can either attack the pinned piece one more time with something like bishop g5. What else can you try to go for? Okay, that's the most straightforward move. That's the one that should pop into your head right away, chat. Bishop h6, right, or go for the other pinned piece. Any of the two pinned pieces is fine to put pressure on. Rook takes. He can't take back with the bishop because he's pinned. If he takes with the queen, we take back with the bishop and we're winning. He's double. Okay, that's fine. Fortify. Rook takes. Just take it, man. Take it. He's gonna have to take with his queen. This is okay too. Just take it at some point. At any point. Just take that knight. Let's go. With the bishop. Okay. Okay. Hi, mom. How are you? dashing tango with the white pieces. He's been brought on by sub-battle leader Alexander Botes to see. Sorry, if he can lose to 25-11, because we are actually playing with the black pieces here. We got a Nimzo, which is honestly a super solid opening. I'd recommend to a lot of people. You play it with bishop b4, and you go for instant pins or d5 if he wants to play more of a queen's gambit declined. Okay, queen's gambit declined. This is okay as well. I flipped the board. Chat. This is from the Phantom Menace. I think in the Phantom Menace, didn't the dark side win? I don't remember. Okay. So far, so good. I don't know why Dashing Tango gave up his bishop pair so easily. No? Nobody won? That was Revenge of the Sith. Got it. Dude, we have 25-11. Thank you, Parker Jam. Appreciate the 2 months. Okay, c5. We're going for the center. The problem is d5 is actually a strong move here. Because you don't want to trade off your light-squared bishop. Then your entire position is going to collapse. So you have to castle. And now a move like e6. e6, I think he was supposed to play here. But this is still good. Bishop takes so that we're removing the defender from e5. Beautiful play, 25-11. We're going to win that pawn real soon. Oh, whoa. What just happened? Okay. Knight takes e5. What is happening to the board? Sorry. Okay, chat. We're up a full pawn. 2 minutes to 2 minutes on the clock. Up this c pawn. This is a difficult position to win, but even if we get a draw, we win this sub-battle. This knight and queen can work together to bully that g2 pawn. Thank you so much, Major Zaroff. I really appreciate it. Okay, the queens are traded. That's okay with us. We're up a pawn here. We can play a6, attack that bishop, push him away. b5, push him away one more time, then hit him with the c4. Straight jab, right punch, let's go! b5, c4. You take him out, 25-11. Look at 25-11. He even has his Botes flair on chess.com. Speaking of, if you guys are getting into chess, if you use our chess.com link, it supports the stream as well. Just do command chess. This is only if you're going to do it regardless, okay? Okay, so our rook is under attack. Six, beautiful move here. And it is such good technique as well. You didn't know that. Did we miss a fork? I didn't see it. What are we going to continue with here? Knight f4 I like. g3. Can we play something like knight e2? Equal pawns again. I know. A minute and 14 and equal pawns. Rook takes or double up. Both are fine. We need to make sure this knight doesn't get trapped. Honestly, do we have to take it back right now? No. Rook d8 works too, and then we can get our rook to d2. You want to get your rook on the second rank whenever you can. This is a threat. Don't fall for bishop takes f7. Don't fall for bishop takes f7. You got to move your king, buddy. Get out of that check, sir. Really, any dark square will do. Very nice. King g7. Uh-oh. We're down on the clock, and our knight, remember that trap, he has to go to c1. The rook cannot take it because of... No! It's okay. It was hard to see. It's okay. We're still playing well. We still might save it. 24 seconds to 58 seconds. Let's get those passers moving. Get those pawns pushing, boy. I don't know why I said boy. King f6. Take. Very nice. We got those passers. Let's keep them moving. Let's hustle them. Let's hustle them over. Okay, we're just going to have one pawn now. That's okay. One pawn's all we need. Move that king somewhere? No? retreat it. Okay, this is fine too. I think we just have to try to play fast. We're probably going to lose this regardless. Oof. Okay. It's over. This was... We may have lost the battle, but we are winning the war. We are winning the war. It is 5-4. Anna needs to win the next game to tie the score. Chat. 2008 King versus Joe Bruin. Happy birthday, Mr. Vila. You wish he has better taste in music, Mr. Manuel. Change Twitch game. This is our game. This is the final game. I don't know about you. I'm not going to sing. I'm not going to ruin the song. Okay, so far, very solid opening. We had a scotch where you push D4 and trade off early. Opposite side castling again. So what are we going to try to see? I mean, we need to get this bishop out first. So how are we going to get this bishop out? I know I'm tone deaf, chat. I know. Am I in New York? Yes, sir. I'm in New York, and it's not a great place to be right now. Doesn't have the magic of New York since everything is closed. But it's nice. I've been able to see some friends in, like, safe settings. So I'm going to be with another friend. We're just going to stay outside. Safe. Ish distance. At least it'll be nice, you know? I'm happy. Okay. So, knight e5, bringing the knight to the center. We still need to bring out the bishop on f1. H3 first is kind of a weird move. It didn't really seem necessary because there wasn't a knight that was going to go to g4. Okay, the bishop's under attack. Let's retreat it. Very nice. 2 minutes at 219. Joe is playing this very well. Joe is underrated. Okay, let's move the queen out of the way. Where do we want to move it? We don't want to allow knight e4, so we can't play queen d2. That's why queen f3 makes sense, so that this isn't a threat. Then we're going to take out our bishop. This bishop needs to come to the party. Where does he want to go? Bishop d3 is one option, but then we have to deal with queen g5. Check. Queen g5, I guess we just move our king over. Yeah, it's not so bad. Does this song make me feel younger? I'm 24. I'm still young. Okay. No more old jokes. I feel like... Yeah, I was gonna say that I've had enough experiences for two lifetimes, but really I've probably not even had enough experiences for how old I am now, since I'm always in school or working or on the computer. But that being said, you know, when COVID opens up, I'm going to travel and I'm going to take you guys with me, and it's going to be super exciting. But until then, I'm going to still be stuck on my computer living like I could be, you know, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, or even 20. Really, any age. I live like a grandma. That's fine. Andrea said I was Netflix and chilling. No, I was hanging out with my roommate. But we were watching UFC, which isn't Netflix. But it was good. It was fun. Until I fell asleep. Okay. Dude, why do I always fall asleep? Holy smokes. Okay. Focus on the game, chat. We have a minute and 10 to a minute and 30. This is the point that is going to let Team Anna tie up the score. She's going to tie up the score. Back to Duel of the Fates. Happy birthday again, Vila. Boom. All right, 2008 King. So, what are we doing here? Thank you, Pizza Dizzle. Really appreciate it. And Mermaid, thank you for gifting. Really appreciate you guys. 52 seconds. 2008 King, you have to play faster, man. I know it's a tough position, but you're not down any material. Why are we taking so long? He took 22 seconds and he... 22 seconds. Okay. Bishop takes, queen takes is fine. All right. Trade. Put queen to f5, trade off pieces. If you trade off pieces, you're going to be able to play faster. But you got to play faster, 2008 king. You're an NM. You're a national master. You can do it. Pre-move knight takes f5. Pre-move it. Okay. Good. After queen takes, what happens? Let's say he brings his rook to e8 to protect the pawn. There's so many moves you can play quickly here. Joe Bruin is also playing like a slow Joe here. I like it. That's what we want to see. We want to see a slow Joe. Bring your rook to the open file after just traditional moves. Okay, tied pawn, time. 32 seconds to 32 seconds. This is okay, chat. We might be able to do it. Rook takes, that's fine. Okay, bring your knight in. Bring it to c4 after he should play e2, but he didn't. Good. Don't let him get his rook there. Let's go. That's fine, too. Just don't flag. 25 seconds. Speed is your game, baby. Let's go. Okay, rook f3. g3. Trading off 20 seconds to 21. We're catching up on time. Now we're coming from behind. Chat, if you've been watching me and you haven't learned it's the best from behind yet, then what are you doing with your life? The rook always wants to be attacking from the opposite side. Good. Rook c5. We're going to take this pawn. Take it. Good. Rook. Ooh, be careful. Ah, he missed. He slipped. Oh, God. 7 seconds. Oh, gosh. Oh, no. We're going to lose. We're going to flag. Remove. This is a drawn position, but you got to pre-move all the way, buddy. Yes. Take that pawn. Yes. That draw is all we need. 5.5 to 4.5. We are victorious. We are this week's sub battle champions. Chat, winner point of view, baby. Winner point of view.